So what's the best thing you like about Diwali at your office? The bonus? The gifts? Or do you like to unleash that inner artist within you at that Rangoli making competition? Well, why not, right? Rangoli banana to banta hai yaar. At least it doesn't pollute the air or make you go deaf. So you thought that Rangoli is all about arts and aesthetics? But did you know that it was not always about decoration and was more about purification? And that was very problematic. But what is the history behind Diwali Rangoli? Rangoli, or flow paintings, are made using rice, either powder or paste, colored sand and flower petals. But the art of making Rangoli isn't just restricted to Diwali. It is widely practiced across India and on different occasions as well as non-occasions. In Bengal, it is called Alpana, Aripana in Bihar, Kolam in Tamil Nadu, and Mandana in Rajasthan. Since it is a transient art form, unlike sculptures, it is difficult to trace its exact historical origins. And why is a Rangoli made? It has been a part of Indian folklore since ages. However, it is not just about beautification and decoration. As per mythological belief, Rangoli is made to welcome Lakshmi, the goddess of wealth and prosperity, who is worshipped during Diwali. But why is it problematic? Is there something more to it? Yes, because it is also about purification. According to art and culture historian Jyotendra Jain, in ancient times, Rangolis were made to purify households. The Sanskrit word for it is lipai. It means cleaning the polluted surroundings outside your house, preferably using cow dung. So what is wrong if houses were clean? Safai to zaruri hai Diwali pe. Because it was not about cleaning the surroundings from dirt. It was about cleaning the so-called impurities. Our society was, and to an extent unfortunately still is, deeply caste-rooted, where untouchability was the norm and people from the lower castes were considered impure. Their presence was considered inauspicious. The lipai was done to purify the surroundings, which was supposedly contaminated by the lower castes. Shameful, isn't it? But hardly surprising, since our history is all about caste-based oppression and discrimination. But is it the same today? Thankfully, it isn't. Because Rangoli has evolved from being a mere ritual to an elaborate form of art. Not just festivals, Rangolis are made on almost all special occasions. So the next time you bring out the artist within you to make Rangolis, remember that it was not just meant as a tool to decorate.